Good afternoon, delegates at the Fourth Platform for Disaster Risk Reduction. I really appreciate the opportunity at the last minute afforded me by Sophia Ashera to make a presentation. The idea I would like to share today is not a new idea, but it's not an obvious one in tackling disaster management. And basically, it's the use of social media as a tool to tackle disaster management. Social media is changing the way people communicate, not only in their day-to-day lives, but also in unusual circumstances such as disasters, terrorist attacks, and other emergency situations. Networking sites such as Facebook and Twitter can help individuals, communities, and agencies gain valuable information, share emergency and evacuation plans, and establish a line of communication between networks. A most useful tool when traditional communication infrastructures are damaged as a result of the disaster, such as in the Haiti earthquake of 2010 and the Japanese tsunami catastrophe of 2011. There is an extensive paper called Japanese Tsunami Social Media Report by Dr. Karen Freeberg of the University of Tennessee that anyone interested in can have a look to find out more about how social media was used in the Japanese tsunami. Smartphones are very popular now. In my country, Nigeria, because I'm here representing the National Emergency Management Agency, smartphones have become as cheap as $50, and most people connect to the internet via the smartphone. And therefore, it will be a good consideration for most agencies and individuals to look at using those new media devices as tools for communication, especially during crisis or disaster management. I won't want to take much of your time because I only have 15 minutes. And what I'll try to do over the next 10 minutes is show you slides of how we've used social media as a tool in disaster management in our agency, the National Emergency Management Agency. First, as you can see, we set up a Facebook page, which is for us a way to establish a community and a network. This was in the beginning. Early last year, we had 2,156 followers. We are over the 10,000 figure now. And this helps us identify people we can reach out to in the Nigerian community. The next is to spread the word. For example, you can see we've posted on our page that we're at this event here. And so everything to do with a global platform we have put up online. We use it to get attention. We have what we call the Emergency Management Volunteer Corps, and we have a separate page set up for them, and we use this platform on Facebook as a medium to reach out to them. And if we needed to mobilize them to a certain location, we send messages out to them through Facebook. We get feedback from people about the job we do. We get messages from people about disasters. Like, we've had messages from people in remote parts of Nigeria telling us about bridges that have collapsed or buildings that have collapsed. And it's a cheap, real-time form of communication. Once you have a new media device, like a phone, a tablet, or whatever, you can use it through whatever networks you have. We use the platform to answer questions as well. People ask us questions about the locations of our zonal offices or questions on DRR. And so this platform, as you can see an example there on the slide, is how we do that too. We use this to provide support. I'm not sure you can read, can you make it bigger? Other NGOs and agencies dealing with disaster management sometimes contact us, especially the independent agencies, to give them support in terms of relief materials, organization for dispersing to disasters. And this is how they reach us sometimes. Some of the organizations that approach us, we have never had dealings with them before, but because they've seen our profile online, they get in touch with us. in emergency situations. A typical one here was in Nigeria last year, we had a Dana plane crash, and we were using our Facebook page to communicate with our own field officers and emergency managers on the field. We're also using it to get feedback from members of the public who were giving us information about where certain debris and damages to do with the plane crash were. The next slide also shows part of that same activity at the plane crash. Here is a slide of a collapsed building. And we got the information about this collapsed building right on Facebook, and we deployed our search and rescue officers there. And when the operation was ongoing, we documented and get comments and feedback from members of the public as well. That's a second slide from the collapsed building. That's an example of a collapsed bridge that was sent to us. A message was actually sent to us on Facebook. It is also a tool to motivate and empower our staff. We have zonal pages for our zonal officers, which give the initiative to the staff to carry out the work. And when we publicize what they're doing, it actually motivates them to want to do more, to go the extra mile to serve the organization. We use our social media platforms to organize simulation exercises. We inform our stakeholders of our plans for the simulation. And when we carry out the exercises, we put pictures or videos of those simulations exercises online as well. That's another simulation slide there. We use it to reach out and create awareness. As you're all aware, we had a very devastating flood situation last year. We started to develop banners, which we put out online. And sometimes we actually pay Facebook ads to promote these banners so that they can reach us a large amount of people. If you pay Facebook, they spread the messages you have to people who are not even following your pages. So sometimes you can reach up to 20 to 30,000 people with one post. These are other examples of public awareness posters we put online. There's the River Niger that was flooded last year. And so those are different campaigns as well we have. Well, thank you very much for your time. These are our links to the social networks we have. And I will leave by showing you a little video that probably will leave an impression on you on the powerful tool that social media is. Is it the video? Excuse me, the technician is working on the video there. Any luck? Thank you. Sorry. We also use other platforms like Twitter and Flickr, Skype for internal and external communication, and I employ other agencies to probably consider and look into the idea of using social media in dispersing their work. Thank you very much, everyone, for your time.